Hi everybody, this is Boomcow, and I am going to start the scenario Lancing the Abscess, which is all about, I assume, counterattacking the American forces in Italy that landed at Salerno. It's the 16th of February, 1944, Anzio, Italy. The enemy landings at Nettuno are the start of the planned invasion of Europe for 1944. All German forces must be possessed with a fanatical desire to emerge victorious from this battle and not to rest until the last enemy is eliminated or thrown back into the sea. It must be fought with bitter hatred against an enemy who wages a ruthless war of annihilation against the German people and who, without any higher ethical aims, strives for the destruction of Germany and European culture. It must be driven home to the enemy that the fighting power of Germany is unbroken and that the invasion of the year 1944 is an undertaking that will be crushed in the blood of British soldiers. So that sounded like very propagandic, or propaganda. By the end of January, the Allied forces had pushed inland far enough to create a long, narrow salient along the Via Anzioti. I hope I said that right. 3 miles long and 1.5 miles wide. The chief of staff of the 14th Army indicated that the salient was positively demanding to be counterattacked. General von Mackensen was given the task of counterattacking the beachhead, but he decided to delay the attack a few days in the hopes that the weather would improve. And then there is a long story there, and more story. And let's get to the mission. Alright. Your mission is to drive south down the Via Anzioti in an effort to crush the Allied beachhead. Your immediate objectives will be to capture the overpass, the railroad crossing, and several tactically important clusters of farmhouses. You are in command of elements of the 735th Grenadier Regiment, the 29th Panzer Grenadier Regiment, the 508th Schwer Panzer Abteilung, and the 103rd Panzer Abteilung. The 26th Panzer Division and the 29th Panzer Grenadier Division are waiting behind our formations for the opportunity to exploit our success. Enemy forces. The U.S. 45th Infantry Division has been in position opposite us for about a week. Their front line runs approximately parallel to our front line from a point just behind the overpass. Okay. The plan. The ground conditions are muddy, so you should try to keep your vehicles on the roads as much as possible. Use your infantry and artillery support to blast your way through the American front lines. This is no time for finesse. It's time to hit the enemy with the hammer blow of German military might. Notes. If you are passing under the overpass, you should probably plot your move to pass directly under and through it. If you stop under the bridge, or if you end up at an odd angle close to it alongside, you may end up popping up onto the railroad tracks passing overhead. Ew. Okay. So, Americans, we have mortars, 81mm, 120, we have WESPs, 105s, 150s, and rockets as well. Very impressive. Alright, so we start, I assume, with a company or two, and we're getting reinforcements. One more company, a battalion, a platoon of tank destroyers, and another platoon of tank destroyers, and then I assume that's two Tiger platoons. Oh, wow. Check that out. Wow. John Martina really put a lot of effort into this, I can tell. Wow. That's amazing. Alright. So, destroy US units. Ground objectives. Touch ground objectives occupied, and 1,000 points for miscellaneous parameters comes out to 5,000 points. All right, let's get in here and check it out. Oh, look at that. It's at night. Oh, wow. What have I gotten myself into? Oh, dear. That is a lot of units. This is a big map. Okay. Yep, I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. So, wow. Let's see what our chain of command is here. Fourth company. Okay, so the 1735th Baden. Who is this? Alright. So, it looks like I have an entire battalion on the field. Four companies. Looks like a heavy weapons company or platoon. First company. Second company. Third company. That looks like just, yeah, that looks like just half of a company. Let me see here. Fourth company. Don't mind if you hear a funny noise. That could just be my cat making noises. Okay. Fourth company. Machine guns. Oh, wow. Lots of machine guns. Alright. Well, hopefully I remember to do... get, you know, use some micromanagement. I'm very bad at that. Alright, so Baden is over here. Who is this? 229th Frankfurt. Another battalion. First company, third, second. Oh, so fifth company is right here. Fifth company is all the infantry. Where's sixth company? Nope. All right. So they haven't all arrived on the field yet. Who do we have here? Okay, 8th. Okay. 4 observers. That's always nice. I like to have extra. And let's look at our tanks here. Just make sure the graphics are right here. All right. So, 103 Panzer Stugs. I like Stugs. Stugs are good. You'll get to witness a lot of Stugs blowing up today. I'm a fairly gung-ho, aggressive player. It's always nice to remember that these are just pixel trooping. So, I'm just trying to have some fun. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this. But yeah, there's no guarantee I'll win at all. So we have one battery here. Another battery here. So two batteries of Stugs. And, ooh. 508th. Tigers. This could be interesting. Oh, wait, it's not on the field. Okay. Okay. Well, I am going to, I think, considering this is a lot of units and could take me a little bit, maybe even an hour or two, I'm gonna go ahead and pause this video and do some, you know, tactical analysis here, and I'll be back, and we can start this. Alright, see you in a bit. Howdy folks, this is Boom Cow, and I am getting pretty close here to being able to start this scenario. So, what I was thinking was that we're going to move to the right here toward the wadis. And I guess this is like a marsh, and we're gonna, you know, scout out before we do anything. And I'm gonna push up to this railroad, which gives me a pretty good idea of what might be over past this farm here, because the briefing specifically says that the Allies run parallel to our line. So I am going to assume that they are in this area and in this area right here, and that I need to focus on a specific point and push that and try to, you know, punch a hole through, and then I can flank forces over here from this way. So here's this road with trees. It dips a couple of times, so it'll be interesting to see what kind of guns or infantry might be on this road. So that's my thinking so far. Now, if we go over here, and we look on this flank, I have a machine gun platoon sitting here, just in case the Americans decide to attack. But it came to my attention while doing ground level examination that I could get infantry toward this direction, toward the crossroads, by hugging the left side, and I won't expose myself to too much on the right in the middle. Because I imagine, you know, after a certain point past this objective, or even this objective probably has American troops in it, that I'm gonna run into a really nasty defense, and I don't want to play toward the defense's strength. I want to play toward mine. So we have the Tigers over here. We have the Stugs over here. The Stugs are a better infantry support tank, really limited against anti-tank because they are a turretless vehicle. So, I mean, they can take out a tank no problem. It's just if the tank gets on the flank, it's most likely going to be a dead Stug. So I'm going to do overwatch over here at the factory with this Tiger platoon. I'm going to send four tanks forward over here and one tank over here and one other tank. Third tank and second tank will move up along here. And what I'm hoping, let's push this up here a little bit, There we go. Is that I will get the ability. Look at that. Bad line of sight. Yeah, it's pretty bad. So yeah. Stay on the roads. It's muddy. Conditions muddy. Light fog. I was wrong before. It's not at night. It's actually in the morning. So I assume it's going to get more light out as we go along. Yeah, so let's get going here. I have 2nd Zug platoon, I guess. 2nd company with anti-tank Panzer Strike. And I am going to go ahead and put these troops down here. Whoops. Break off a scout team. Move these guys forward. And I want them to walk to here. And then hunt to here. Nice big hill here. Either they're going to be on that hill or they're going to be behind it. I'm hoping they're behind it. I really want to feel out this whole sector here. Obviously, the Wadis is going to provide, I guess, the most cover for infantry. But I'm sure the defenders know this, so it's going to be very tough to break through there. Alright, what do we got over here? So I am building up a reserve. I don't want to commit too many troops. So here's 3rd Company. In fact, wherever 2nd Company is. Ah. We're going to move these guys back over here. And I'm just going to keep these troops. Back here. And put that guy in the house. There we go. All right. And then we have machine guns up here. The factory. 4th Company. Some of the 4th Company's over here. Huh. I'm actually going to take that platoon and bring it back here. And then 3rd Company is going to be in reserve over here because my idea is I'm going to come down this road, take over these houses, scout out the overpasses, and then see what's on the other side. Same thing over here with these infantry from the 29th Frankfurt. They're going to move ahead of the Stugs and scout out this overpass. I actually want to look over it. I don't want to so much look under it. So we're just going to, you know, move to this area and get on top of here and hopefully get some spots without getting shot at. So let's see here. Team move up. All right. And where's my other Adventure Scout Team. Alright, and we have a scout over there. Artillery, no TRPs, so that means I want to get mortars, and especially these howitzers. Oh wow. So, definitely the rockets, 13 minutes. I'm thinking somewhere in here, maybe even here, or we go down. No, I'm gonna save this. We're gonna go down via Anzanati with the artillery. So, oh, 400. Somewhere, as long as I cover that house and something down here as well. So we'll go 6, heavy, maximum, immediate. Cover. Howitzers. I don't know, that just, it feels like a waste of artillery not knowing where these guys are at. Maybe between here. No. This is a nice complex. I'm sure there'll be some enemies there. I think we can afford to drop some 120s on it. And I think I am just going to go down that road with mortars. I just think we'll be better off just using 81 millimeters. So go down. Ooh. They cannot reach the other side. Oh. Interesting. Okay. Nah. The wasps can. I'm gonna go put some fire, I think, on this. Let's get those 81 millimeter mortars to put fire right behind this railroad, because as you can see, I can't see behind them. Actually, you know what? I can. I may not just use all these artillery. I just might set up some. Go down Anziani here. No. Let's go ahead and wreck dog. Maybe we'll get something out of it. Medium. General. Alright. So, even by looking at those artillery, you can tell I am definitely favoring the right. Over here. Going to keep whoever might be in Rooster down. And I'm gonna give this guy the job of calling in a 120 millimeter border strike on the goat. We'll go down the rail line here. I'm gonna assume by all these that this is meant to represent the possible positions of allies. Now, I won't waste artillery on this because I have so often seen map designers put this in and there not be anything in the end that was ever here. So I'm gonna just leave that. Let's go ahead and no, we're gonna save all that. All right. So, Oof. Lots of terrain here where I would be exposed. Really wishing for some mechanized infantry right now. All right, I have everybody kind of ready here, and